In Kenya, the main problems are within the public health sector, but also a big problem in the livestock sector, because one, of course, we have not had a national program for surveillance for a long time. We only have data from Sentinel surveillance, which tells you that we have bits and pieces of information from areas where research has been done. But on the overall, there is a huge problem. Sometimes you find that antibiotics are only about 25% work in some places where they are actually required. In other instances, you find that one E. coli organism can be resistant to up to eight antibiotics at the same time. So it's a big problem. It's a huge problem, and it's not properly monitored. So just like any other developing country, you find that there's a lot of information gaps because we don't have systematic surveillance in place. So it's a big problem. Yeah. In our setting, sometimes you find that the official channels of importation that can be monitored account for only a proportion of antibiotics that are commonly available for human use and also livestock. So there are always parallel markets. You find that maybe officially only 60% can be accounted for, but what about the other 40%? It means somebody is importing in a parallel market that is not accounted for in terms of usage in the country. So, and some of these antibiotics end up in very remote areas because they are being promoted by salespeople because they want to make a profit, and they go to the farmer and tell them, yeah, you can use this to prevent disease in your camels, in your livestock, in your goats, and so forth. So the farmer will just obviously take upon themselves to try something new because they have seen animals die, but they don't go for professional help from those that are trained as veterinarians, for example. You find the same thing in human health. Find in some remote areas, families don't want to go a long distance to consult a doctor because it's going to take time, it's expensive. So they go to the nearest chemist of a pharmacy shop and ask for help from there, and they can buy over the counter any kind of antibiotic. Maybe it may be a generic that is completely off. Some of the generics that are imported are not necessarily the best quality. But because they have come through a parallel market, nobody is able to monitor their quality. So there are a lot of challenges in developing country settings. I think for some time now, the government has wanted to stem the rise of antimicrobial resistance, because in human health, you can already see the effects. You know, you find patients staying longer in hospitals. You find a lot of mortality of children who don't respond to treatment when they are taken to hospital. You find livestock dying in some places, a whole flock of chickens dying because of a disease outbreak. So there are a lot of indicators that antibiotics are not working in some places. So what have we done? The government has now fully embraced the World Health Organization Global Action Plan to develop local plans or local national action plan that can be domesticated for use in our own country in Kenya. And we have begun that by first doing a situation analysis. We want to understand what happens on the ground in both livestock and human health. We already have a publication showing some of the key areas where antimicrobial resistance is a problem. We have also done a situation analysis showing or indicating where most antibiotics are used and for what purpose. So even with some basic information, it can be able to inform policy about where can we start in terms of implementing the National Action Plan. And also, the government has now endorsed a policy document that will now drive activities for implementing National Action Plan. So with that, we can be able to start by being able to bring all stakeholders together, in livestock, in fisheries, in agriculture, in human health, and we have brought all of them together to be able to utilize this National Action Plan and be able to implement in their various sectors towards, one, awareness, creating awareness, two, doing surveillance to be able to inform them about what's happening on the ground, and three, being able to introduce simple measures aimed at reducing usage of antibiotics, such as introducing policies on stewardship of antibiotics, infection prevention and control measures, towards improved sanitation, for example, in livestock settings, for example. And all these are measures in a small way that will bring reduced use of antibiotics and hopefully minimize resistance.